Now, on to reviewing the Kevin Costner movie that some people would argue might have inspired a certain James Cameron epic. And no, it's not Waterworld, it's the other one. Hello YouTube, FilmBuff06 here, coming your way with a review of the 1990 Western war epic Dances with Wolves, which was adapted by Michael Blake from his 1988 novel of the same name. It was the directorial debut for leading star and co-producer Kevin Costner, and it also stars Mary McDonnell, Graham Greene, Rodney A. Grant, Floyd Red Crow Westerman, Tantoo Cardinal, or Tantoo Cardinal, Michael Spears, Robert Pastorelli, Tom Everett, Maury Chaykin, and Wes Studi. It is also influential for being the film that essentially revitalized the Western genre, which up until this point had suffered a decline in popularity due to the colossal box office failure 10 years prior of Michael Cimino's Heaven's Gate. Now, Michael Blake originally wrote Dances with Wolves as a spec screenplay as far back as the early 1980s, which later went unsold. However, after previously working with Blake on the 1983 film Stacy's Nights, co-producers Kevin Costner and Jim Wilson took an interest in the project and managed to persuade Blake to turn his screenplay into a novel so that it could be more sellable for the studios. Production on the film was a true nightmare from hell for Costner. Not only did he have to contend with various production delays because of unpredictable weather conditions in South Dakota where they were shooting, the difficulty of directing wolves that were untrainable, and the complexity of the Indian battle scenes, but he also had to contend with the fact that he went over the initial production budget of $15 million because he broke several unspoken Hollywood rules for first-time directors. Namely, they traditionally avoided both shooting outside and working with children and or animals as much as possible. And as a result, he was forced to pay $3 million out of his own pocket for compensation. Even worse, this led to rumours from Hollywood bigwigs and trade papers who thought the project was going to turn out to be just as disastrous as Heaven's Gate, which was considered at the time to be the most mismanaged Western in film history, and thus they satirically dubbed the project Kevin's Gate. Fortunately, though, Dances with Wolves not only became the highest grossing Western of all time, with over $424 million worldwide, was not only later selected for preservation in the United States National Film Registry by the Library of Congress in 2007, but it also received 12 Oscar nominations and only took home 7 awards, including Best Original Score, Best Film Editing, Best Sound, Best Cinematography, Best Adapted Screenplay, Best Director, and better still, made history by becoming the first Western in 60 years to win Best Picture. Now, the story of Dances with Wolves is set in 1863 during the American Civil War and is about a depressed U.S. Army lieutenant named John Dunbar, played by Kevin Costner, who unintentionally becomes a hero by leading his fellow Union troops to victory after attempting to kill himself during a suicide mission. As a reward for his bravery, he requests that he be reassigned to a remote post in the western frontiers of South Dakota, where he befriends a wolf that he names Two Socks for its white forepaws, encounters the Sioux Indian tribe, eventually falls in love with and marries a white woman named Stands With a Fist, played by Mary McDonnell, who was raised by the tribe since childhood, begins to earn the tribe's respect, and gradually becomes integrated into their culture and way of life. So, was Dances with Wolves really deserving of the 1990 Oscar for Best Picture? Now, I know some people would say that Goodfellas was the better film that year and therefore should have won, and that Martin Scorsese should have won Best Director instead of Costner. And of course I could see where they are coming from with this argument, you know, from a certain point of view. However, I don't really see the point of the argument, really, nor do I think both films should be compared with each other in the same sentence. I mean, both Goodfellas and Dances with Wolves are really good films in their own right. And I would have been genuinely happy with either one of those two films winning Best Picture, to be perfectly honest. To be perfectly honest. And with that said, what are my thoughts on the movie itself? Wow. I am almost speechless because this movie is incredible. It just seems to work on every single level possible in terms of filmmaking as an epic Western with some amazing action sequences, a sweet romance between the two leads, and some gentle humour, you know, something for everyone, as a character piece, and literally, and really as a celebration of the Sioux Indian culture in general, and Native American culture in general as well. You could nowadays make the argument that the story is quite predictable and has already been told only 3 times before. In this film, The Last Samurai with Tom Cruise and James Cameron's Avatar. But you'd have to remember that at the time, the story felt fresh and it felt original, and it was something that nobody had ever actually seen before. For his first feature film as director, Kevin Costner does some of the best directing he's ever done in his career so far. Michael Blake does such a fantastic job with adapting his own novel to the big screen, and the subtitled Lakota Sioux dialogue is handled superbly well. I also like how this film portrays the Lakota Indians as real people with the same decency and sensitivity and you know, dignity as other human beings, and not as the uncivilized, thuggish and savage enemy that they have been stereotypically portrayed as in the past, you know, in the 50s and 60s. And I also like how it portrays the Union soldiers as imperfect and flawed people, not as the two-dimensional, mindless, you know, vicious brutes that they could have been in far less capable hands. The acting is great from everyone involved. I mean, Kevin Costner, yes, he does have his detractors in the acting department who accuse him of being as wooden as a plank, you know, almost like the Sam Worthington of his day. But I thought he did a great job as John Dunbar and managed to bring a certain likability to the role that makes you seriously want to root for him throughout the movie, proving to us why he is, in my opinion, one of the most underrated Hollywood actors working today. The supporting cast all did a great job at their roles, especially Graham Greene as Kicking Bird, Rodney A. Grant as Wind in His Hair, and Mary McDonnell as Stands with a Fist, who are all brilliant. You'd also have to bear in mind that this is a very, very long movie. It's actually the longest movie I've ever reviewed on the channel so far, believe it or not. Anyway, it is just under 3 hours long, or 4 hours if you watch the extended version. And yet, I wasn't in the slightest bit bored, but instead, I was engrossed by it. And I love the fact that Costner used this length to give the story and the characters more breathing space and more time to develop, so that we, the audience, can get emotionally invested in these characters and care about them, and care about them through time, and care about them. The cinematography, courtesy of Mad Max veteran Dean Semler, is incredible, and it really adds to the epic scope of the film. Plus, the South Dakota locations look beautiful on screen. The score by John Barry, especially the theme tune, the da 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 da. Da 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 da. That just has to be one of the most iconic and legendary film scores of all time, next to the likes of Star Wars and Jaws and Harry Potter and E.T. I mean, all the great classic film scores. My favourite action set piece in the film just has to be the iconic buffalo hunt, which, believe it or not, Kevin Reynolds helped Costner to direct before they went on to collaborate a year later on Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves. I mean, from the way it was shot, paced, directed, acted, edited by Neil Travis, and scored, it was an absolutely awesome scene on an epic scale. I also loved the flashback sequence where we essentially get to see Stands with a Fist's origins and how she became a part and how she came to be a part of the Sioux tribe. That was such a beautiful, and emotionally powerful scene. The ending in which, spoiler alert, Wind in His Hair shouts out to John in subtitled Lakota Sioux from the top of this mountain, "Dances with wolves, I am Wind in His Hair. Do you see that I am your friend?" Can you see that you will always be my friend? That was just an unbelievable scene on a profoundly emotional level. I actually had almost a dry tear in my eye when I watched that moment. I mean, just absolutely just if you are a Western fan or have never seen Dances with Wolves before in your life, I would very highly recommend that you check it out. It might be a 3 or 4 hour long movie, and it might seem pretty boring from a lengthy sort of perspective for people who don't seem to have wider enough attention spans whatsoever to watch a movie for more than 2 hours. But I can guarantee that I can firmly guarantee that those people will be blown the hell away by this movie, as I was. So, in conclusion, Dances with Wolves is one of the greatest westerns ever made, one of Kevin Costner's best films by a country mile, and it absolutely deserves my overall rating of an awesome-tacular 10 out of 10. Now, feel free to leave a comment in the section below and let me know your thoughts on Dances with Wolves, whether or not you think it deserved to win Best Picture, and what your favourite Kevin Costner film is. Plus, feel free to subscribe to my channel as always. And until my next video, which is going to be a review of An Education with Kerry Mulligan and Alfred Molina. Do take care, everyone, and goodbye.